this, like, maybe around age 16. You know what I'm saying? Until then, I was just, you know what I'm saying, in between singing New Edition songs and, you know what I mean, and Troop and all those guys, you know what I'm saying, and Woo and the Girls and all the talent shows, I was in between that and rapping, you know what I'm saying? It was a guy, at Wilson, his name was Master McBride. And Master, he was like a DJ, you know what I'm saying? And like, he had Clayton Holmes, and he had, I can't remember the other guy, oh man, I feel so bad, but I can't remember the other guy. And I remember in between sets, we used to practice and for the show. And in between, like, Master would be back there cracking jokes and cutting on the records. You know what I'm saying? I already knew how to cut and scratch and all that stuff from Odell and them boys in Florence. You know what I'm saying? From the whole boys, we used to cut and scratch on his daddy's on the record joint. So I already knew how to cut, but I never saw anybody talk with it before. So I'm singing New Edition, but I'm watching these guys do this hip hop thing, and I liked it. I love the girls, but it was just something about this thing that they had going on with the, you know, with the hip hop and rap. So, you know, I started to lean that way, and around age 16, I went to the studio with a guy named Starchild, and I did my first recording with a guy named Starchild, and after that, we stepped up the game and we moved to a guy named Fred Shaw. Fred Shaw, his father had got him a studio, or he got him a studio behind his father's car lot. And it was the big reel to reels. We had the big old reels about that big. We had to record on it. Like, you had to be precise. You couldn't mess up. You know what I'm saying? It was a time, but yeah, 16 to 18. That's when it got serious for me, because around that time we wanted a record deal, or either we wanted to start our own label.